Let's move on to the next oral presentation with the title of Development of Hydropulse Seeding Assay for Identification of Mucus Production Inhibitors as Potential Therapy for Asthma, presented by Mr. Chantapon Yim Nuan from Faculty of Medicine, Ramathibodi Hospital, Mahidol University.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Chantapon Yim Nuan. Today, we are talking about the way to find the new drugs in asthma. As we know that asthma is a chronic inflammation that affects the huge number of the people, with the number is to be increasing over year. The prevalence in Thailand is about 5% and more than 10% in the children. And these patients suffer from breathing difficulty and asthma exacerbation and death. Normally, asthma occurs when the allergen come into the airway and then recruit white blood cells to cause airway inflammation, smooth muscle contraction, and mucus overproduction. And these three processes lead to airway obstruction and impair ability to breathe. The current treatment of asthma are focusing on inhibition of inflammation and smooth muscle contraction, but many 5 to 10% of the patients do not respond to this kind of treatment, and corticosteroids have an effect to promote opportunistic infection. So why don't we look at mucus overproduction, which is another characteristic of the asthma that directly causes airway symptom. Therefore, inhibition of mucus production may improve asthma outcome without causing opportunistic infection. But unfortunately, we do not have the inhibitor and do not have the tools to find them. Therefore, this study aims to develop the tools that can discover the inhibitor of mucus production. In this study, we use 16 HBE cells, which is an airway epithelial cell line. We seed this cell into the 96 well plate. To induce mucus production, we use LPS, which is one of the allergen in asthma. But we don't know the concentration to produce mucus, so we vary the concentration from 0 to 100 micrograms per ml, and then see which concentration produce highest mucus production. And then we stain with PAS, and the mucus is indicated by magenta color. So the results show that only the 100 microgram per ml of LPS can increase 3-4 of the magenta color compared to the control. And we can see the magenta color is here on the 100 microgram per ml of LPS. Therefore, we select this concentration for further experiment. So the next question is that, is this system validated? To validate this assay, dexamethasone will be used because it is the standard drug for asthma to determine whether this mucus is inhibited by this drug or not. The results show that LPS can increase the mucus compared to the control. And in the presence of dexamethasone, the mucus is gone. Therefore, dexamethasone can treat this mucus. To assess the quality of the assay, we calculate the index we call C factor. The higher level of C factor indicates a more excellent assay. And we found that the C factor is 0.65, which is higher than 0.5. Therefore, this assay is excellent and ready for the screening. Another question is that, are there any compounds that can inhibit mucus production? To answer this question, we test one compound for one well, but now we have 96 wells, so we can test 96 compounds within one time simultaneously. And after the test, if some compounds have more than 50% reduction in mucus, so we will regard as an active compound. And the results show that only XP1 that can inhibit mucus production below 50% of the control. Therefore, we select this compound for further drug development. Another question also coming to my mind that, can XP1 inhibit the mucus production in a reality? To answer this question, we use clinically relevant mouse model of asthma. We inject OVA into the mice to make it become asthma, and then we treat XP1 to determine whether XP1 can inhibit asthma, inhibit mucus production in asthma or not. The results show that OVA can increase mucus production in asthma compared to the control. In the presence of XP1, the mucus production is gone and or significantly less than that of the control, similar to dexamethasone. Therefore, XP1 inhibit immune class production. Because inhibition of inflammation can cause opportunistic infection. Therefore, we test whether XP1 inhibit inflammation or not. By staining the lung with HNE, and the results show that OVA can increase inflammation characterized by infiltration of white blood cell compared to the healthy control. In the presence of XP1, the white blood cell is still there. Therefore, XP1 cannot inhibit inflammation, but dexamethasone can. Therefore, XP1 inhibit milk class production without interfering inflammation. In conclusion, we successfully developed the assay to screen a lot of white one time, and we found XP1 as an inhibitor in both in vitro and in vivo assay. Because asthma can occur when allergen cause inflammation and milk class production and that cause asthma symptom. Currently, we have dexamethasone that inhibit inflammation, but it can cause opportunistic infection. But in this case, we have XP1 that inhibit only the mucus production, but not inflammation. Therefore, it may have lower chance of getting infection opportunistically. Not only we can use this assay, but you can also use assay to find your own compound, your own inhibitor that can treat not only for the asthma, but also for COPD or pseudomonas infection, or another disease with high mucus production that can help 5% of people improving quality of life and resiliencing the health system. If you would like to know more information, please contact me or my advisor. Thank you.
Well, such an interesting topic. So do you have any comments or any questions, please?
When you induce mice with oral albumin, did you determine the IgE level or not?
Actually, in my experiment, we do not determine the IgE level because we do not interested in that, but we interested in the downstream effect, which is airway inflammation in the lung.
Thank you.
For the magenta, thank you. That you evaluate the mucus production, the magenta, the proper one, yes. Do you have any internal control in that picture? I mean, do you have any the washing step for that? If you washing too much, the magenta may be fade. How do you make sure that that is the real result?
Because we do all the condition at the same time and for the same step of washing. Therefore, it is an internal control that can control that the control and the treatment are washing with the same step. Because it's in the same 96 well plate and we wash together.
May I ask? I appreciate your experimental design, but if you start with the asthma model, why do you use the LPS, which is the, I'm not sure whether usually is the component from bacteria or what, to study the mucus secretion. And the mucus secretion itself, as you summarized in the latter slide, it can be produced under many conditions. So how would your experiment specifically answer the asthma questions?
Oh, interesting question. But actually, in the mucus production, it can occur from the airway inflammation first. So there are no, maybe there are no activator of the mucus production alone without inflammation. Therefore, we use the cheaper one, which is the LPS. So to induce the asthma, but actually it does not induce only the mucus, but it can induce inflammation. So therefore, some compound that test in this assay may be inhibit inflammation, but we have to test next whether it inhibit inflammation or not before we go on. But in this case, we accidentally find that my compound did not inhibit inflammation, but it specifically inhibit the mucus production. Hopefully, I answer your question.
May I ask another question? What is the reason that you use the dosage of 20 milligram per kilogram of the XP1 to the mouse? And yeah, what is the basis after that?
Actually, this compound is not published before, but I see the publication that published the compound with the similar structure, but the study used the same dose with its 20 microgram per kilogram, and it do not show any toxicity at all. So we use this dose for the mice, but in further study we have to study with whether the high dose can cause toxicity or not, or it can inhibit more mucus production or not, because it will be better if we use more dose and then we get more decrease in the mucus production.
All right, please give a round of applause to our presenter again.